Welcome to the Perfect Gospel Broadcast with your host, Evangelist Frank Houseworth, along with Sister Renee Houseworth. We come here each and every Wednesday evening for 2 big hours from 6 to 8 p.m. You can call us at 404-246-0238 for questions or comments about this or any other broadcast. For prayer or counseling, call us at 404-246-0238. Now, here is Evangelist Houseworth with the subject.
We want to say greetings to you, the YouTube viewers. God bless your hearts, bless your souls today. Thank God for you. Thank God for you being there. In another YouTube telecast, we are so delighted that you are there and we are here. Thank God for you, Sister Renee. Thank God for Brother Eric, our producer. You probably won't see him, but he's here, and we want to thank God for him. And thank God for Christ Church. We're located in Atlanta, Georgia. That is at 260 Forest Parkway and Old Dixie Highway. Sits a big, beautiful church called the Amazing Grace World Outreach Church. We are in the annex. We're in what is called the Daniel Chapel. We are here today, and God bless you. As I say, God bless your hearts, bless your souls today. Won't you stay with us? We have a message for you today. We have some information for you. We're going to give, hopefully, to those that are sheltering in with their little children. We have a former school teacher here. That's Sister Renee. She's going to give you some little tips how you can bless and be a blessing to your little children. God bless you. Let me give you our theme, aim, purpose. God in heaven knows we do have a reason. That is Colossians 1:28, the great Apostle Paul, who is said may have been the greatest Christian that ever walked this earth. Here's what he says. He says, whom we preach, warning every man and teaching every man in all wisdom, that we may present every man perfect in Christ Jesus. YouTube bills, he's only echoing what the Master had already said. When he walked this earth, 12 men were with him. When he went to the mountain, he was set, and he gave the beatitude, the beatitudes. This is what he said in the 5th chapter and the 48th verse. He said, be ye therefore perfect, even as your Father, which is in heaven, is perfect. And we oftentimes say, this is the greatest invitation that you'll ever get. Makes no difference that we live 106 years. I heard a beautiful lady, she had been on this earth 106 years. But this is the greatest invitation that we'll ever get. When our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ invites us to be like God, not only does he invite us, he makes us. As John said in St. John 17:23, I in them and thou in me, that they may be made perfect in one. This is the word of God. God bless you. Thank you for being with us. Sister Renee, how are you?
Just wonderful. Thankful to the great Lord.
Amen. Well, it's a blessing, Sister Renee, to see you. It is a blessing to have you here today on this fine day, this great Sunday. And we want to thank God always for all that he do and all that he is to us. And we want to say that we have something that we're going to offer you, those that are seated, those that are still sheltering. We have a brochure here called 7 Days with God, 6 Promises that if you would go on the back, as you would see on the screen, rather, you would see our information there, and you can download to us and send us a text or whatever you do. We will send this right out to you. It's 6 days. You study 6 days, every day for 1 day for 6 days. Study the promises, and on the seventh day, you meditate and you pray on that seventh day of the promises of God. We know that there are a lot of people that are hurting right now. There are a lot of things going on in our world. And it's so prayer is much, much needed. If we can't do anything else, we can pray. We want to thank the Lord for those that are on the front line, the nurses, the doctors, the medical people, the scientists, those that are working hard, working around the clock, trying to come up with a cure. And we thank God for all those that work in various places, work in the grocery department stores and various places. A lot of love is being shown. Mm-hmm. Those in different restaurants who have may not have been able to open up, but you have opened up your heart and shown a lot of love. And as I like to put, I want to thank God for the little children,
yes,
those that are at home, and they've sent so many beautiful things out to those elderly people, those that are in nursing homes. And thank God, and Sister Renee, I thank God for the love that is being poured out to different people in different places, and those that are feeding those that are running out of food. And it's just a lot of love and a lot of kindness. And we want to remember those that are incarcerated, and we still have homelessness. So remember those that are homeless. And Sister Renee, I want you to comment on this quickly. Women and those that are being abused. It's such a horrific thing, you know, for this to be going on top of everything else. What would you say to the womanhood?
Well, as I've gotten a lot of texts today, and as the world giving tribute, they're giving tribute to mothers.
Yes.
Mothers today, and they are trying to, people, women and men are trying to express themselves to say thank you, you know, for deeds that the womanhood through motherhood has done to help their families.
Mm-hmm.
And what I would like to say to the ladies that it's a stressful time. Consequently, it's a stressful time because mothers and women are having to take care of the children and do something that they might not be adjusted to doing, like teaching the children at home. And some of the ladies are not able to go to their jobs because of the fact that they have children that may be unattended from the schools and from daycare. So it presents a lot of turmoil in the home. And you know, when you're housed with maybe a spouse, husband, you and the children, and maybe you have babies that are not school age, it can produce a stress and a disorientation between the two people, and then you can't go out like you know, to send your children to school.
Yeah.
So this can cause people to be stressed in stressful situations because they're at home and personalities flare and some, you know, honey to-do list and a lot of different things going on. So it's a natural thing that you might have stress, and it can result in abuse. As I saw an article, as I mentioned on last week, about this stepdad who wanted his son to abide by the stay at home and not be out on the street. And they got in a confusion with one another, and now the son, stepson, is dead. And I imagine that's a hurtful thing.
Oh, yeah.
So I would say to the womanhood, because I know that women try a lot of women try so hard. They have to manage the children and the household, and in these days they are at home. Some of them can't work on a job because they don't have a babysitter for the children or school for them to go to. So what I would say with this situation, to pray and start your day out with Jesus. Pray without ceasing. Pray and say to God that this is your day and I want to glorify you, and please help me through this situation.
Yes.
And you know what? God will help you.
Amen.
He loves you. Mm-hmm. He will help you. And you can start out the day by having devotionals with the children. Just take maybe 5 minutes. You might not be able to take a long period of time. Just take 5 minutes and teaching them how to pray. Teaching them. I remember when I was a little girl. Now I lay me down to sleep. I pray the Lord my soul to keep. If I should die before I wake, I pray the Lord my soul to take. If we could teach our children how to pray, to acknowledge God and first acknowledge God, then I believe, and just to really get close with God, He will fix the discipline problem. He will fix the unrest in
Amen.
The home. And I just thank the Lord.
Thank you, Sister Renee. And we pray that that those that are viewing us, that they will take in deep consideration the things that you have said. And what we want to do now, we want to go to prayer. We want to go to prayer. But before we go to prayer, I want to just ask those that are viewing us to get their Bibles if they can, and go to St. Luke chapter 21, the 21st chapter of St. Luke, and we're going to read one verse, and then we're going to go to prayer, and going to come back and talk about this today. St. Luke 21:34, Sister Renee.
And take heed to yourselves, lest at any time your hearts be overcharged with surfeiting and drunkenness and cares of this life, so that day come upon you unaware.
And let us pray. Eternal God, our Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, Father, we pray. We're asking you at this hour to look on every soul that is upon this earth. Wherever they may be, dear God in heaven, we're asking special prayer for those that are in various hospitals and various places, Lord, being cared for. Mm-hmm. We're asking you to look on those that are caring for them and give them strength and courage to carry on, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Such an incredible work. We want to thank you for those that are on the front lines, those that are working, those that work seemingly, dear God, around the clock to make sure that the world be fed, even in that sense, Lord, that they get in the nourishment that they need. And we're praying for every soul that they would gather in their mind and get a new mindset.
Yes.
To start thinking of heaven and eternity and thinking of the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ, that they would get prepared. As the old prophet said to Hezekiah, set thine house in order.
Mm-hmm.
And this we ask, dear God, that you would bless every church family, every child, dear God, those that are at home, those that are in the home receiving their education. Bless teachers around the world, and bless all that we do here, that it may be well-pleasing in your sight, that something may be said that will bless us and enable us to have hope. And that hope will carry us on from this earth on into glory, because you said Christ in us is the hope of glory. We love you, Lord. In Jesus Christ's name we pray. Amen. Thank you for praying with us, those that were able to pray. Sister Renee, thank you. Just formally greet the YouTube viewers.
Greetings and salutations, and I do love you.
Greetings and salutations, and we do love you. Just for a few moments here, we're going to talk about a new mindset. And this, I believe that God is redirecting our hearts and our thoughts. The great apostle Paul writes in Colossians 3:1, he said, "If ye then be risen with Christ, seek those things which are above, where Christ sitteth on the right hand of God. Set your affections on things above, not on things of this earth." And it's, we're speaking to you in a spiritual sense now. Is that the mindset must change. We must change, although there are many things that we are changing physically. We're having to shelter in place. Many people are having to wear masks and gloves, and yeah, we're having to stay 6 feet away from each other. We're doing things. We are very, very careful about where we go and what we touch, and we're careful about washing our hands.
Yes.
Those things are very good. And I want to say that we are concentrating. A lot of us are very, very focused, not so much on self. There is a lot of love and giving being displayed. And I want to personally thank God for those who are participating and engaging in such action. But I want to go to the Spirit and share with you in this way. When I say the Spirit, we're talking about our Lord Jesus Christ. When he says that set your affection on things above, we got to start looking now beyond the earth, because the things that we know, the things that we have experienced, they may not ever come back. The things that people once enjoyed as a group, in the physical sense, they may not ever come back. But we need to look now, we need to start looking to heaven. Looking to God, where our help come from. And he says in St. Luke 21:34, he says, "And take heed to yourselves, lest at any time your hearts be overcharged with surfeiting and drunkenness and cares of this life, so that that day come upon you unawares." Verse 35, Sister Renee.
"For as a snare shall it come on all men, all them that dwell on the face of the whole earth."
Verse 36.
Watch. "Therefore, and pray always, that ye may be accounted worthy to escape all these things that shall come to pass, and to stand before the Son of Man."
And this we want to say to you, the YouTube viewers, that there are some things that are coming. We are in the time right now of a great pestilence. Mm-hmm. As our Lord said, that would come pestilence and earthquakes and wars and rumors of wars. We're in that particular time. We're in a pandemic. But in a pandemic, our hope is that we set our hearts, that we redirect our thoughts, redirect what we value. What is it that we have that we will take out of this world with us, and that is our soul. Our soul will go when we go. So we want to do all that we can physically and naturally for people. We don't want to neglect that, but then we don't want to get overcharged with this life. Mm. And Sister Renee, a lady that looks to heaven, that looks, as David said, to the hills from whence cometh her help. Mm-hmm. How important is it, you think, that a lady redirect her thoughts, her values, mm-hmm. where she may place her values at now on this earth? How important is it that she look spiritually now?
All right, I feel this is like this pandemic experience. Mm-hmm. It came very swiftly, and we didn't even hardly know it. Because back in February, I was thinking about how we were just natural, you know, just naturally showing love and just being together. There wasn't no boundaries, and we were doing. But the pandemic experience came like a thief in the night. Mm-hmm. And so when Jesus come, just like that experience came, everything started changing. Businesses were closed. People were staying inside. And then we had the mask, and then the tape on the floors of different establishments, and people were scared. It just came like a thief in the night. So consequently, I'm thinking that we don't know when Jesus is going to come. And this is just one experience where things have changed in that. People, you can't go to all-you-can-eat buffets anymore. You don't have a salad bar anymore. The salad supreme fixed. And all these different things are happening. Graduations have been canceled. Schools have been closed down. Churches closed down, and a lot of things, all in just a thief in the night. The virus came to our recognition as a thief. So what about the next phase? Could be that Jesus could come at the hour, a thief in the night. Now, if a woman wants, they're tired of being shut in, all of a sudden, when the bands are lifting, you go out and you just frolic and have parties and do things like that. Then what about when the next, this could be a sign that Jesus may come, because we don't know when he's going to come. It could be at midnight, it could be at 2 a.m. Mm-hmm. Why go just loosely again?
Yes.
And then you'll be... you won't be happy when you see his face, but it could be, this could be happening, that God is saying for a woman, now that we are in this situation,
yes,
to pray more, to be in his word more, to not have loose behavior,
yes,
not seek for just going to the beach and doing things that are contrary to,
yes,
holiness. Maybe this is a time to get to be ready when Jesus' appearance comes.
Amen. Very well put, Sister Renee. As we get ready to leave you, we want to go back to St. Luke chapter 21. And we're going to read verse 25 and verse 26.
And there shall be signs in the sun.
All right.
And in the moon.
Mm.
And in the stars.
Read.
And upon the earth.
Read.
Distress of nations with perplexity, the sea and the waves roaring.
Verse 26.
Men's hearts failing them for fear, and
right,
for looking after those things which are coming on the earth, for the powers of heaven shall be shaken.
And what we want to tell you here as we leave, we want you to think, this may be only the beginning. This may be only something that is just the beginning of sorrows, as one of the writers recorded our Lord Jesus Christ is saying. When he said these are the beginning of sorrows.
Mm-hmm.
We want to stay where we can stay in hope.
Yes.
And that is, for we look not on the things which are seen, which are temporal, but look at the things which are not seen, which are eternal. And Sister Renee, take about 30 seconds.
Yes, I also would like to say, don't be weary in well-doing. You know, in this life, sometimes your body can make you feel weary because,
yes,
you know, you have a little aches and pains. But I found an inspiration when I had weariness in my body too, that it's,
yes,
a rejuvenation when you say, well, I'm not going to be weary in well-doing.
Yes.
And all of a sudden, these joints, these bones come alive, and you can make it through any day,
yes,
with Christ. And
thank
I just
you.
Thank the Lord.
Thank you, Sister Renee. Very well said. And my plan of action, this is what I want to leave you with. I want to leave you with these words. Overload. Overboard. Don't get overloaded with and be oppressed. Don't get weighed down.
Yes.
Don't be burdened. Don't let misery overtake you. Don't let it drag you down. Get a hold. Take heed to yourself. Don't get overboard. Overboard means to be out of the boat, into the water, into,
yes,
danger. In that sense, stay steady. Stay prayerful. Fast and pray. Talk to God. And I believe and I know that we'll get through this.
Yes.
Let us pray. Eternal God, our Heavenly Father.
Yes.
It is in Jesus' name that we thank you. Father, as we continue to walk, bless our minds. You said in your word that thou would give him perfect peace,
yes,
whose mind is stayed on thee. Help us, dear God, to keep our mind on you, to look not on the things of this earth, not get over involved into those things that really have no spiritual value.
Yes.
But bless us, dear God, to look unto heaven and change the way we value, change our cares, change our hope. Not hope that we could get something that would not eternally satisfy our souls. But help us, dear God, to look unto thee, which is eternal. Help us to know that there is a place where there will be no pestilence, there will be no crying, there will be no sorrow, there will be no death. That place is in heaven with you throughout eternity. And in Jesus' name, Father in heaven, we pray.
Yes.
Amen.
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 God bless your hearts, bless your souls today. We hope and we pray that you will see us on the other side. God bless you.